ladies and gentlemen, have you enjoyed yourselves this evening?
Yes!
I said, have you enjoyed yourselves this evening?
Yes!
They've done really well, haven't they?
Yes!
Good. Now, I know this is not a church, but unfortunately, there's the same rules apply. You have to pay to get out. So there will be a collection, and I'm going to say this every 5 minutes, which I've been told to remind everybody. So nobody is under no illusion that you've got to pay to get out to help raise money. Are we ready? Yeah. Just saying something about Chloe, who did that last piece on her own. If you hear the click track, it's very difficult to play drums and keep it dead in time. That was a grade 6 piece that she did some time ago and got a distinction playing that particular track. It is difficult. When somebody goes, a drummer goes into a recording studio, you get that little click track in your ear to make sure that when the rest of the band join you, they try and keep in time with you. You've got to keep dead in time for the rest of the band to be able to put their tracks on top of it. So to play to that click track, it's difficult, even for professionals. So I think she did very, very well, and I think she deserves another round of applause. Have you all heard of Duke Ellington?
Yes.
If you haven't, we're going to just about to. 1932. It don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, go!
Thank you.
introductions over. Ah, right. This one's going to wake you up. Bill Holman is a very prolific American composer and a big fan of Ranger. And this is one of his numbers called the Jump Out. No, just about the Jump Out over here. I promise you. One, two, one, two, three!
Thank you.
sure you know, it just shows that he does do something other than sit in an office. Mr. Fowler, stand up and tell your oh, right. Yeah. Oh, yes, before I forget, before you go out the door, there's going to be a couple of big buckets. Now, I don't think it's the school pupils, I think it's people of the oldest generation, so please be mindful of the weight. Paper is a lot easier, and it makes it like a lot easier for them to count it afterwards. Right, this is the number they called me out. I've been on holiday, and I came back last night, and I was expecting to play a particular number, and I got it tonight, and they said, we're not playing that, we've changed it. Well, thank you very much. And I haven't got a card, so I'm doing this from memory, or lack of it. It's called 90. It features Ollie on drums. It's one of the pieces I brought along last year, and the band fell in love with it, hence why, with my bachelor's term, they put it in the program. 90. Faster now, I'll get my own back.
Thank you. I haven't seen you very much, apart from as a performer, so I'm Peter Mason. I'm the head of the current head of music. I'm actually leaving to go to America to live with my wife, who's now in America in July. I've been here for about 3 years, and it's been absolutely fantastic. So this is actually my last concert. So when I say I don't do anything, I do live in the music department. I heard there is life outside the music department, but I've never seen it yet. And I definitely haven't had lunch, probably about three times in the 3 years I've been here. So I just go home and pass out afterwards. But it's a team effort, and the strategy I took, I used to be an assistant head teacher, not very good one, I have to admit. The strategy I learned on my master's was distributed leadership and making sure everybody's really heavily involved and everybody has purpose. And I couldn't do it without the team, and my strategy has always been, since I've been here, to put people in place with enthusiasm. So, since anything, I'll just say that I said this at Christmas, Mr. White, so could you do that? And he's just arranged it. But it's not just teachers like Mrs. Nunn and Alistair, Andrew Deacon, and all the people who run the groups. It's also the students. So, I mean, we have students in leadership positions. For example, Kirsty, who's invaluable in the music department, who leads all the admin quite a lot of the time, and the pop squad, and Chloe, who leads all the musicality and all the music in the jazz band, and Jack, who never gets a mention off me, I must admit, we're always arguing about everything, but his standards really help the music department get to a really high level. So it's been a fantastic ride, it's been very challenging. And I'd also like to thank Tasmin Fowlis, who's my friend and colleague. It hasn't always been easy because it's a very intense department. We've been trying to improve our grades, which we now have. But it's been absolutely wonderful working with her. Without her, we wouldn't have all the choreography and show part, which has now been passed to Molly Rennie, who's actually doing the choreography, and we've actually got a student on piano, so I think it's absolutely wonderful that students are leading groups. I'd also like to thank my line manager, Sarah Bavarius, who has got me out of quite a lot of tight situations. She's one of these wonderful assistant people who keeps herself in the background, but without her, we'd never be able to do anything. Andrew Fowler, who recently came on board, and ever since he sung a song, you know, I was worried about singing with year nines, because when there's 30 year nines in the entire class, it's quite hard doing high level chorus singing with them. But when I saw Andrew Fowler sing with 100 people in the assembly, and then an entire cohort of 1,000 in this assembly, I thought it can be done. So without him to inspire me, I wouldn't now love Renaissance and medieval music. I'm not quite there with medieval music, but Renaissance music I'm definitely there with. It's challenging for performing arts departments right across the country at the moment. It's become performing arts in general has not been seen a priority. So it is critically important that like events like this and groups like this happen, and musicians see their musical lives as part of an academic culture now. And it seems to be working. It particularly works really well at this school. We have lots of staff making sacrifices and lots of people as well. So it's wonderful, for example, having St. Peter's Choir come all the way just to sing that part, which is absolutely fantastic. I'd also like to thank Patrick Dunn, who, again, I keep saying this every time, I just can't believe we have a secret concert pianist as a chemistry teacher, so I'm really pleased that I will be working in music next year. Dave White, and finally I'd like to thank all the students at Dane Court, particularly all the people in the background, like the tech crew, all the people who do the costumes and everything like that. Again, particular mention to Kirsty, who does a lot of the admin for some of these groups. It's absolutely fantastic. So thank you very much, it's been a really interesting time, and I think we're on the right tracks now, so I'm very excited about seeing how Dane Court Music Department expands in the future. So thank you very much.
It's been a good few years together, and I shall miss him very much. And we do have moments where we are at one another, and at moments where we are laughing our heads off. And I know that the students and I are going to miss him dearly, and we wish him the very best for the future. So it's just a...
Two Johnny's son and it's good night from him. Well, it's good night from me as well. Thank you ever so much for coming, and don't forget to trip over the buckets on the way out.